Hi guys, and welcome to another Elementor video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we've got another little Elementor hover effect for you today, and you don't need any plugins to use this, and you can do it with the free version or the paid version. If you don't have Elementor, you can find the link below the video. So we've got an image here. When we hover over it, it's going to pop up an image box with a smaller version and a link and some information. And that's a nice little feature to have on your site. Really easy to do. So let's get started. I've got this page open already with Elementor. I've got a section, blue tab, with two columns, little dark tab for columns. Let's start working on this column here. So like I say, this can be done with the free or the paid version. We're using the free plugin, or the free modules here, I should say. There it is, image box. You get that one with the free version. I'm going to pop that in there. First thing I want to do is choose an image to go in the little box there. Then you can put in whatever title you want. And put in your description. I thought it'd be a nice idea just to put a little, like I've done on this one, click image for more info, because the image is actually active as a link, whereas the text not so much. The title is there, but if you hover over the description here, it's not. So to do that, just write. Now there's no way of actually just putting a space in there and getting this go down the bottom just by using your return key. As you can see, it stays where it is. But what we can do, we can use a little bit of HTML and put a break in there, which is a pointy bracket, BR, another pointy bracket. As you can see, it's on a different line there. And if you want to put another one in, it'll pop it down another space. So that's just simply pointy left bracket, BR, and a pointy right bracket. As you can see, that's dropped it down a couple there. Fantastic. And here we go, put your link in down below where you want to take whoever clicks on it. And best practice, if you're linking to your own site, leave it as it is. If you're linking to somebody else's site or off-site, open it in a new window so that your site stays open. Okay, let's pop over to our style now. Spacing, I'm going to leave it as it is. That actually pushes the text down further or brings it further up. I'll leave that on the default of 15 there. You can type in a value, use the slider, increment with the little arrows right here in the box. Width, I want my image to take out the full width that's available there. That's great. Don't want any border radius. Don't want a hover animation. There's all kind of different animations you can put on there. And that's for the image itself, but I'm going to leave mine just as it is. And I don't want any opacity or transition duration. Again, opacity is sort of see-throughness. You can have one on regular and one on hover, but for what we're doing today, see, it becomes regular size, regular opacity when I hover on it. For what I'm doing today, this isn't going to really apply. So let's set that back how it was. And as with most settings, if you do something and you don't like what you've done, simply go in there and delete it. It'll go back to the default for you. Okay, in the content, I'm just going to make my title black in color. I'm happy with it to be aligned at the middle. If you wanted to, you can change the vertical alignment, but I'm happy with mine to be where it is. Okay, so I'm just going to make my title black. Hit on the color there, drag it down to the bottom left corner, 0000, that's black. Obviously make yours whatever color you want. You can change the typography here, the font, the size, weight, transform, styles, decorate, all the regular text editing features that you normally get with Elementor. But for expediency, I'm going to leave mine just as it is. Description, same options right there. So I'm happy with that. I want to take that fade effect off there. I'm just going to hit the little cross there and go back to none. There we go. Great. Okay, so we want this to fade into a bigger version of the image, or vice versa. We want to see the image and then have it fade in with the details here so they can click on and book it, or whatever it is you want to do with it. So I'm going to go into the column. I'm going to adjust mine so there's a bit of spacing, but we want to get rid of that padding at the top. So to go in the column, let's go into this little dark tab right here, and we'll edit our column. And if we go over to advanced, I'm going to take away any padding. I'm going to put a zero in there. If we've got this chain linked, it does all four at once. But I'm going to add a bit of margin, which is outer space. I'm going to put 20 all round, which will make it the same size as that one next door and give them a little bit of separation there. And again, if you've got the chain linked, you can do them all separately. Okay. Well, that's looking good. Now I want to put a background image into our column here, because what we're going to do is have the image show like this one here, and then we hover over it. We want the actual module to pop in like that. So let's go to the style, background type, hit the little paintbrush. You can have a gradient if you want, or you can put a slideshow in if you want. But I'm just going to have a simple image, and I'm going to choose the same image. As you can see, it's sort of gone over our background because we've got no actual background color in our module, so it's showing the image through. But I want that image to actually cover the whole of the area there. So size-wise, I'm going to have it cover. So we've got a big picture there that goes up the top there. And when we create our hover effect, this will all disappear. Okay, so we're pretty happy with that. Now, I'm missing a bit of padding on the bottom because our actual module is stopping where that blue line is, but we can fix that when we go back into the module. So let's do that and start getting our hover effect to work. So I'm going to go back in the module, the little blue tab up there. First thing I want to do is give it a background. I'm going to give it the same background color as our page. You don't have to, but you can give it any color you want. So let's go up to advanced. And here we're going to find the background. And again, I'm going to give it classic little paintbrush there, simple white background, top left hand corner, FFFFFF, six Fs. Okay, and we want to fill out that bottom bit so it covers the bottom of the column right there. And the reason that's sticking out is because it's matching the height of our column next door. So to do that, I just need to add a little bit of padding to the bottom of our module here. So we'll go over to advanced, the advanced tab at the top. I'm going to uncheck the chain this time because I only want to put padding on the bottom. And I'm just going to add 50. Add whatever you want. I know that's 50 purely because that's what I gave this one. Okay, so we're in pretty good shape now. But we don't want this to appear until we hover over it. We want to see the larger image. So to do that, we need to write a bit of custom CSS. And don't let that put you off. Any CSS I write now, I'll put below the video. And you're welcome to copy it, use it how you will. So we're still in the module right here. And we're still on the advanced tab and the advanced drop down. Here you'll see CSS ID and CSS classes. I'm going to use a class and we're going to give it a unique name. Call it whatever you want, but it's got to make sense to you. So I'm going to call mine imgbx for image box. And now we can write some CSS. If you're using the pro version, you can write it in the custom CSS box down here. If you're not using the pro version, once you've put your class in, you can go to your theme customizer. Just go to your dashboard, down to appearance, customize, and right at the bottom there, you'll find additional CSS. I'm using the free 2020 theme for this at the moment, and this is common to most WordPress themes that I know. They'll have an additional CSS box in your customizer. And as you can see, I've got a lot of CSS written in here already. For expediency, I'm going to write mine in my pro box right here, just so we're on the same page. And I'll show you how to do it with your customizer. Very simple, it's exactly the same thing. So we gave this thing a class of imgbx, image box. So we need to write custom CSS. Be a good idea to give it a title. And a title is a forward slash, star star forward slash. Anything that you write in between the two stars there will not be read as code. It's a great place for putting title or notes when you've got CSS. If you write a lot of CSS like I do, that's always a good idea. Helps you find things, and also it's a courtesy if anybody comes in behind you and edits the site. So I'll just call it image box hover. Okay, let's drop down, and we gave it a class name. All class names have to have a dot or a period in front of them. So it's dot, and then the class name, imgbx. Now we want to open and close some curly brackets. And inside those brackets is where we write our code. So I don't want to see this thing initially. So I'm going to say opacity 0. As you can see, it's disappeared and left us with that nice image there. But when I hover over it, I do want to see it. So I'm going to copy this whole thing from the dot all the way down to the closing curly bracket. Control C. I'm going to drop down a couple. Paste it in there. Now, after the X of imgbx, no space, we'll put a colon, and then no space again and the word hover. If you put a space in there, this will not work. And I'm going to change that opacity to 1. And putting the colon hover after there is telling it that when you put your mouse on it, we want it to do this bit of code. Now, opacity 0 is totally transparent. Opacity 1 is fully visible. And you can have increments in between 0.1, 0.2, etc., all the way up to 0.99. So now, when I hover over, you see it pops in. But that's popping in absolutely instantly, which you might like. But for me, I like to slow it down for a bit of drama. It's just too quick. So we can do that in the regular state, not the hover state. We'll add a transition duration time. So if we drop down, transition, dash duration, colon, and give it whatever time you want. 0.5 seconds, 0.1 seconds. I'm actually going to make mine quite slow. I'm going to give it 1.2 seconds, 1.2s. Now when I do it, it should be a lot more graceful. There we go. But again, that's entirely up to you. So it really is as simple as that. And if we check that out now, we'll hit the little eyeball down here to preview our changes. There it is. Let's just roll this down slightly so we can see the whole thing. There we go. And that is a nice little effect there. Now, like I said, if you're not using the pro theme, you just do this exact same thing. I'll just copy this and you put it in your custom CSS box here. Just simply paste it in there or write it in there. If you're writing to this box, what you can do is go back to home page settings, and whatever page you're working on, you can temporarily make that your home page while you're doing this so you can see it in real time. But you don't have to, you can have both pages open. You can have this page open and this page open, so you can just write the code here and test it out here. But I'm going to delete that because I don't want it in two places at once. Okay, what if we want to swap it around and have it do the opposite way around? Just publish that quickly, not that there's any changes. If you wanted to have this bit first, and then when you hover over it, the big image, very easy. All we do is swap those numbers around. Opacity 0, we'll make that 1. And opacity 1, we'll make that 0. As you can see, now we have the actual details, and click image for more. and our image is live, and it does it the opposite. As you can see, we've now got our details and smaller image up. When we hover over, it's going to bring in the larger image, and we can click on it and go where we want to go. But that's entirely up to you. Personally, I like it this way around, because you look at an image and then you hover over it and something happens. So there you go, guys. There's how to have an image box with a link. And when you're not hovering over it, it's just a large image. So we'll just publish this and take a look. And there we have it. Just roll down a little bit so we can see everything. There's the second version, and here's the first version. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.